When I was on city council, we had a lot of interest in this community for sustainability, but there was nothing really in place to bring those things into action. It became very clear that it was really hard for the city as an organization really to have an impact in the community. The schools offered a great opportunity because they touched so many of the citizens. We put together a sketch of a program, called it Reading, Writing, Retrofit, and then applied for the Climate Showcase Grant through the EPA. The grant opened the door to working with the schools, and from there the host of relationships and networks that developed just has continued to grow.
Well, it was nearly $500,000 in a grant, and it enabled a lot of partners to come together.
In March 2010, EPA awarded Land of Sky Regional Council the Climate Showcase Communities Grant to design and administer the Reading, Writing, and Retrofit program in Buncombe County and Asheville schools. The goals of the grant were to implement energy efficiency investments and engender student participation in green teams.
First started with bringing in the facilities managers and the superintendents from the two different school systems that are located in Buncombe County. And we began crafting a path forward to meet the goals of the Climate Showcase Grant.
Our maintenance department, and they for a number of years, even prior to knowing about Reading, Writing, and Retrofit, they have been sort of the leaders in our school system regarding the whole aspect of sustainability and especially from the standpoint of energy.
A large amount of the grant was used for retrofitting 41 schools. Some of these retrofits were dedicated to low-hanging fruit that were discovered by energy audits. The most common of these were the installation of energy-efficient fluorescent lights in gymnasiums. These and other energy-saving measures offered immediate financial savings and a reduction of greenhouse gases.
We thought we could save about 1,000 tons of greenhouse gases annually, and actually we ended up saving closer to 1,300 tons annually. We saved 2.5 million kilowatts annually, and that equates to a cost savings of $250,000 a year. The schools, when they started seeing the energy savings and the impacts to their physical environment, they brought in an energy manager who pushed it even further.
$20,000 was allocated for microgrants to be used for student and teacher projects. Originally, that money was used to initiate 18 green teams.
Reading, Writing, and Retrofit is at the core of this effort for our green schools. And in fact, 24 of our schools received the green school certification. And so each one of those looks a little bit different.
Sustainability ties into our standards in a lot of different ways, specifically in the physical sciences, alternative energy, solar energy, wind energy, and that's very easy for sustainability to be a strong piece in that curriculum.
I work together with all of the classroom teachers to align their curriculum with environmental education topics. Well, the Reading, Writing, and Retrofit funding helped to kickstart our green team. As the years have passed, it's become an institution. The green team is something that lower grades kids look forward to being a part of. And so we've expanded from being a small group of leadership kids in an after-school club to it being the entire sixth grade.
Using a solar panel is important because, well, you don't burn fossil fuels. We were giving a few materials, one 6-volt solar panel, a light, and a battery pack. I made a charger for a phone. For one circuit, I attach my batteries to my charger. That's charging your phone. And when I need to charge my batteries back up, I attach the battery pack to the solar panel, put the solar panel in the sun, and it recharges the batteries.
We built a solar light, and we have a solar panel on the top, and we have our solar light on the bottom of here, and our battery pack. Then when I connect these, the light turns on.
Our green team is primarily teacher-led at this point. We have representatives from each of the grade levels. Here at Hall Creek, sustainability is multifaceted. We wanted more than just ornamental gardens. We wanted functional learning environments, and we have a student-led recycling team, so that helps them reduce their footprint on the earth. And then we've tried to incorporate the students eating some of the food from their gardens so they can really understand the process of where food comes from.
The students do everything in the garden. The students are the ingenuity and creative minds that craft what we do out there. And then they do all the harvesting, and I have initiated a really rigorous edible education program here as well. The water from the garden comes almost solely from the gym roof. We have a very in-depth 8th grade piece of curriculum that looks at stormwater management on our campus and takes content from the lower grades where we've learned about watersheds and how we're a part of a watershed and what we can do to make sure that we're being responsible in our watershed.
The schools embrace their natural surroundings and created outdoor laboratories and classrooms.
Creek Week is a week where the entire 8th grade science team goes out to the creek and we look at readings of different things that tell us if the creek is healthy or not. Turbidity, nitrates, phosphates, pH, dissolved oxygen, temperature, etc. We learn that our creek is mostly healthy, but there is animal feces in it. There's many surrounding farms and whatnot, so when they do what they do and it rains, it washes into the creek.
Cane Creek is what's known as a green school of quality. That's the level that we're recognized by the state of North Carolina. It's earning points on a rubric that's set up across the state for doing different environmentally friendly projects, energy efficient projects, projects that bring awareness of environmental issues to students.
Reading, Writing, Retrofit has morphed into the North Carolina Green Schools program, and we are reaching out across the state of North Carolina on a web-based platform that gives resources to any interested teacher in our state.
It's exciting to be here, to be energized, to see what people can do if you just give them a little bit of a start and continue helping things move forward. That's pretty exciting to come here year after year and see something new happening and being able to trace it back to a relatively small investment that we as a country made through EPA.
The most important thing that we're doing with this project is teaching students about the earth and how they are stewards to this earth.
It's always nice to sit back and see public recognition of the right things. And this is one of those areas that I can truly say I've not heard the first negative. When you think about it, who could throw stones at something like this? I mean, these are life skills that we're teaching.
I think what excites me the most is that we have kind of done what we've set out to do. We look to say, how can you have an impact on a community? And when I walk into a school 5, 6, 7 years later and hear the teachers talk about their culture of sustainability in the school and how they're taking that home with them and the kids are getting their parents to recycle at home, it just makes me really proud that we were able to accomplish what we wanted to do.